Hey guys, this is Coach Chris. Welcome to my channel where we break down international level fights for strategies and tactics that you can use in your own matches. Here we have Uzbekistan versus Iran. Ulugbek is the Olympic gold medalist at 18, beating out Lee Dae-hoon, Hosseini, and Sinden. So we're watching this guy fight a lot. One, because a lot of his fights just come up on my feed now. And two, because he's really, really good. So let's get into it. One more time. Normal aggression out of Iran here. Iran normally tries to fight very dominant. Uzbekistan always has great defense since Nikita, Shokin, all of those guys, really, really good. So this is kind of difficult for Iran because Iran's main weapon is the front leg, like 90% of Taekwondo. This is actually a good little exchange here. 90% front leg, or say majority of Taekwondo is all 90% front leg now, right? But Uzbekistan has this uncanny back kick where if you screw up with your front leg and hit you with the back kick, that's 4 points, right? So it is a little bit harder for Iran and others to press someone like this who has great defense and has a 4-point shot mixed in every now and then. So this is a good exchange. And the reason I pointed out it was good is because Iran here is very, very aggressive. One. And because he's aggressive, usually people in an aggressive state don't think too much on defense. So him, Uzbekistan going back and trying for the headshot with the loud key up here. You can see his mouth key up and loud, letting know returning aggression. Not a bad idea. Not a bad idea. But also keep in mind, as Uleg is fighting, or Uzbekistan's fighting, he attacks at different, nice puncher. He's attacking different targets, different depths, meaning if his opponent's, you know, standing still, just holding call, standing still, he'll kick a little bit deeper sometimes, he'll kick short. He changes depths and targets. That was a good punch by Arendt to get in past that front leg. He likes that little point fake there. Close. That was very close. So this one here is nice. I like this because the last two things, rewind here, just look at the aggression. So Iran here trying to really establish pacing, game pace dominance. And I like this headshot because the last couple of times, I believe, yeah, this last time Uzbekistan backed off. Here is kind of just suckering Iran's front leg in and then going for a headshot. And so it seems like the coaching call was that if you go for Iran's head, nice depth there. If you go for Iran's head in the clinch or just after his first shot, it seems to be open. This was a good attack here. Iran trying to force the pace of the game to his own pace for whenever he wants to attack. He's dictating the offense. Good job, Uleg, here going deep. Really fast and trying for a shot underneath. Nice try. Locking up his hand behind him. Locked up. Iran, I think, is still getting used to the new rules. Nice try going deep again. Seems like this Iran guy's very hot-headed. Not hot-headed like losing his cool, but seems to be a very, very aggressive player. Uzbekistan seems to be like he's holding back a little bit and is capitalizing because Iran is being almost too aggressive. It's not like a Dae-hoon aggressive where he's encroaching and kind of playing safe in a way while he's encroaching. It's very... it's aggressive and it's leaving him open, and so that's where a lot of Uzbekistan's counters are coming in. Nice punch. Nice axe kick there. I don't know if those punches score or not, but nice try. Yeah, front leg punch. Also, I don't know if people are aggressive because it seems like Uzbekistan is like kind of mocking a little bit. So maybe that's what's getting under people's skin. Who does this? Watch this. This I've never seen this combination. Front hand punch mixed with the to the face like that. I haven't seen that before. This was well put together. If you guys, so what I said earlier, that Iran is susceptible after his front leg is going down. It doesn't seem like he's defending his face. Uzbekistan has tried for that twice already. Something else Uzbekistan picked up a little bit earlier in the round was, I think it's here. I think just before this. Here. No, after this, I think. After here is the first one-handed punch. Come on, show me that one-handed punch. One-handed punch, okay. So, they just established you can break the defense of Iran with a front-hand punch. They've also established if Iran lifts his front leg, he's susceptible after that front leg to his head. So all Uzbekistan did here was put those two pieces together. Get past the front leg, get him to lift it, and then kick him in the face because that's where he's weak. Great, great job putting that together here to win out. I think he wins out the first round. And then the cut, I mean, Iran has to press at this point, so not too much to take away there. How does he play this? Uzbekistan trying to get the spin in. Not a bad idea. He has a lot, too many points though to give. Oh, do they replay the punch? Oh, here it is. Boom. Boom. Okay, I want you guys to watch this. So I have a video where I'm talking about in the clinch, you need to look in the opposite area of where you want to score. So if you want to score to the body, look at this guy in his face. If you want to score to the face, look at the body. So I want you guys to watch Uzbekistan here on this slide and punch front leg kick. Here he goes in for the punch. Boom. Where are his eyes? Where is he looking right now? He's looking at the target that he just punched at. Makes sense. He's still looking. He wants, after the punch, he already knows he's going to the head. He already knows. That's already in the combination. But where are his eyes? His eyes are still looking here at Iran's body. Then at the last second, he flips to the face at the last second when his foot is already by Iran's shoulder. Boom. Boom. Still, eyes still low. Eyes are still low. And I think the shift was just as Uzbekistan's foot is passed here on the arm. That's why his arm is low. Just by the way, so you guys know, Iran read Uzbekistan's face, saw the eyes were still low, and he's covering this side just in case he's going low. But he's not. He's going to the head. Good job eye faking by Uzbekistan. It's not like some fairy stuff I made up. Like, people actually use this. I've gotten hit in the head multiple times, firsthand experience, because people have used this on me. I've actually gotten some people also, but it's something people use. Little cheeky, doesn't work 100% of the time, obviously, because nothing in Taekwondo works 100% of the time. But keep that in mind. Little eye fake. So, how do you beat this guy? Well, one, I already know this guy progresses to the final. And given that there's only 3 minutes left, I can only assume he's winning this round, too. So, how do you beat this guy? It's very difficult. You have to get past this dude's front leg. By this guy, I mean Iran here. You have to get hit past his front leg. And you have to do so in a way that doesn't leave you open to the back kick, because his back kick can hit from almost any angle and it's pretty nutty. So you have to cover for that. And then you also have to keep in mind that as you're trying to chip away at his defense, he's varying both the target and the depth at which he's trying to hit you. So you have to have really insane blocking to encroach against this guy. And you have to be willing to, you almost have to do doubles to counter the front leg, and then you have to start hammering with your left leg to block both an attempt for spin here and the front leg counters. So I think that's the way past it, and it's going to be ugly because you're going to clash a lot. But watching this guy's fights repeatedly, I think that might be the only way to do it that I can think of. For Iran here, right now he's very aggressive. Let's see how this progresses. But I don't know if he's going to do that because that's not really Iran's play style. And they like to use the front leg here. Aggressive play by Iran. It's not a bad idea. 2 points in for Uzbekistan. Nice. Okay. Good. So one of the counters that I like to tell you, or other people like to tell you, is if someone's being aggressive, just kick deep to the face. Or if they're in the corner, kick shallow to the face if they're coming. So this is how you break this down. If they are coming in with if they're aggressive but are kind of staying at distance with you, like they're poking but they're kind of in place, then you want to kick mid to long range because they're kind of in place. If they're crashing in at you, like running for inferior blitz, Junseo Bay style, if they're closing the distance and getting you in the clinch, then you want to kick to the face but short because they're going to run into it your leg is coming up. So if they're blitzing all the way in, aggressive all the way in, kick short to the face. If they're mid to long range, you want to kick deep. Especially like my targeting area, when I'm trying to tell people where to kick, is like you want to aim for the back of the shoulder. So if I'm sparring this direction, most people are going to do what when you kick? They're going to lean back. Where does the head lean back to? It leans to about the back of your shoulder. So when you lean back, target that area. So when you're doing drills as a coach, when you're telling people to, when you're giving your kids or your fighters targets, when you're doing this drill, have them hold it behind their shoulder this way, right? So keep that in mind as we're watching. This is a good exchange. There's a lot of aggression. He's now, keep in mind, he's doing the aggression without coming in all the way for the clinch, right? So fighting at range. And then, boom, kicks about one head behind where his head was because he leans back. So scores now up by 5-0. Unable to break the... unable to score during that aggression, that's actually really disheartening that's a real confidence killer to have that much aggression, kick that many times, have nothing score, and then have your opponent's points go up. That's what it's like fighting in Kyudun. You just kick a bunch of times, that guy turtles up, kicks you once, scores, and then it's 2-0 and you're tired. The one time I fought that guy. So Ren's trying to figure out how to... Iran right now is trying to figure out how to prep. Nice try. So I like this here. He's trying to figure out past the defense. He sees he's transitioning. Usually most people are not super aware when they're angling this direction. So that's a good opportunity. We're trying to maximize the opportunity. Did he score off that? That's just salt in the wound already. That's... I feel bad for the morale of Iran at this point because you have all those combos in the beginning, you get scored on, you make a good attempt when the defense is weak, when he's transitioning from one part of the ring to another, you try for a long shot and you still get scored. And it's kind of, that's really like, come on now, let's, you gotta feel a little bit bad. Yes, hammer the backside. Okay, so the rule is if you push without kicking and the guy falls out, then it's a gumjung or a warning. Uzbekistan trying to get some ring space back. That one was really him going out. Good job by Iran. I don't see him making... Actually, it's two. They could be trying to force out for a round win. Maybe that's what the strategy is here. That's why Uzbekistan is really cutting those angles. Force out. Oh, that's a close one. Is there a gumjung? There is. Two more, and this guy wins the round. Okay, that's the game. Two more warnings, and Uzbekistan is out. No, lost it. Close. It's hard to play the shove out of the ring game when the other guy knows that you're playing the shove out of the ring game. Something you could do if you're very tactically minded, I guess, is when they come in like this, pull a Junseo Bay and wrap your hands around this part of the Hogu And so when you do that, when you wrap your hand around this part of the hogu and move your hand forward, it locks Uzbekistan or your opponent's arm forward, and then you can get a gum jung that way. I'm not saying that this should be a strategy. Like when you get in a clinch, you should always do this because some refs may catch on to that. But it looks like that's what Junsei Obey does sometimes, and Junsei Obey seems to win a lot. So if you guys want to win a lot, that may be something you guys want to do. Oh, don't dip your head. Don't dip your head. That's not, don't do that. Kick. Oh, there's some pulling there. That was a little bit of a pull. A little bit of pulling there. Unfortunate. That could have been a call. So overall, another good display of smarts by Uleg. The Uzbekistan, good aggression here by Iran. Key takeaway points for Uzbekistan, it was really, really just overall good defense as always. Able to score in the heat of the moment when pressure's on, especially in the second round when Iran is coming towards him. Able to score, able to recognize that if he's being too aggressive, you kick one head behind or tell your player to kick one head behind where they're at. So you guys, if you're a coach, your parent, set up the drill where someone's cutting hard, and then blitz high and one head behind where their opponent is. That's really, really good tactic. The second tactic for coaches who are watching this, or a good drill to do would be, as people are kicking, you don't have to do a front hand punch into a head kick. Like that's, you can develop that if you want, do a lot of reps. But the thing to develop would be to train your players to look to the face if they're planning to go body, look to the body if they're planning to go face. You saw it in slow motion here. Uzbekistan did a great job and hit Iran pretty hard in the head. Besides that, was there any, did I feel like there's any large setups? Not so much large setups. I think Uzbekistan has a really good feel because so Uzbekistan only fights really in one stance. And so he has a really good feel of the types of offense that can come against him. And he has a really good variation on his defense. Sometimes he'll slide back once. Sometimes he'll close distance with a one-hand punch and try and kick you in the face. Sometimes he slides back, doesn't do anything. Sometimes he'll slide back and return fire to the face. He keeps people at bay with his front leg. And overall, it just seems like this guy's front leg does a lot of work. And people are, it's hard to attack his open side because he has the back kick. So, I don't know, if I were fighting Uleg, or fighting someone who's like Uleg, I'd tell people to hammer the flank and vary between hitting body and hitting face. And you just got to be a lot better at doing that than he is at a back kick. That's it for today, guys. And please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.